Or else maybe if you guys are on the bridge, guys, you can come to my place. I want a bridge. Guys, refrigeration is a process. Like, let's have ideas. What is a refrigerator? Anyone guys, or an opinion? What is a fridge actually in general? The fridge that is in our home. Agreed? Anyone who can come up with a great definition? From your knowledge, not from our knowledge, what is a fridge in general?
Refrigerator.
It's a machine that breaks. Certainly. Okay, it's a machine that keeps certain school. That's what you
said.
Oh, like, okay, guys, it's good, guys, to talk this thing, so we should know exactly what we're doing. Refrigerator, guys, then, it's a process where it takes what? It takes a substance from high temperature then, to a low temperature. For an example, if maybe you go to a bottle store and buy some pills, you'll find out maybe it's very hot, but you put it under the fridge after some certain time. The temperature will go down. Right? So in refrigerator, they're just simply teaching you that process of taking a high temperature, low to high temperature to a low temperature. So in definition, I can say that it's a process that convert substance from high pressure then from high temperature to a low temperature. This is the process. So the main is to do what? Is to bring a cooling feeling. So the main purpose is to bring what? A cooling feeling. So inside like a refrigerator we have many components, né? But the main constituted component we are going to speak about evaporation. We are going to speak about compression. We are going to speak about condensation. And we are going to speak about throttle valve. These are the four components that we are going to speak about. Four components. So, the first component is going to be evaporation. Né? You can go with me together. Let me erase it. You can go with me. I'm going to explain everything using this simple diagram, which I'll say here is evaporation. And I'll come here and say this is compression. And I'll come here and say this is condensation. And I'll come here and I'll say this is what? It's a throttle valve. Something like this. So like, because we're saying something is a process, when you say something is a process, for example, butter. Butter, not margarine, butter is a process. Like it's a process of milk until they made a process until it became butter. Like, so even a refrigerator, it's a process. So there are stages that like the fridge moves from this stage, move to another stage, move to that stage. So the first stage, the fridge starts from here, from evaporation into compression. From compression into condensation, which here I'll say is a stage two. From condensation to what? To throttle valve. And from the throttle valve back to evaporation. So you see the process is repeating itself. Né? The process is just repeating itself. And understand? So let's go through the component, evaporation. We can go through the component of evaporation. Evaporation is what is happening in the inside of the fridge. Inside. So this thing inside of the fridge, like inside. Understand that? If maybe I can draw your fridge, those trays. Maybe here is your 5 kg of fry pack, né? For an example, here is your 5 kg of a fry pack. You know your fridge is always empty, here it's empty and empty. Né? So, what is happening is the evaporation is happening from the inside. Here on the inside, there is a coil. There is a coil that is covering the fridge. Né? That coil is the one that absorbs heat from this, from our substances. So I can say that refrigerator do what? Absorb heat from what? From substances. It absorbs, it's the one that absorbs heat. There's a movement in an, you know that evaporation is a process of removing what? Liquid into a vapor. If you open your fridge, there's some smoke or something that is moving around. You can see it, né? Yeah, just open your fridge right now. You see that smoke? There's a smoke that is moving around. That smoke is caused by evaporation. So it goes it from where? From liquid into that smoke. And that smoke later on is the one that is gonna like cause an ice. So the fridge can become whatever the process we are talking about. So evaporation is a process of doing what? It's the process of absorbing heat. It's the one that brings what? The cooling feeling. We spoke about cooling feeling. It's the one that brings what? The cooling feeling. So after this, it happened. It transferred it into a compression. Guys, what you have to know, evaporation happens at the one. This side, you're gonna split this into two, something like this, no? You just gonna split it into two, and we are saying that everything that happens this side, it's a law. Pressure or a low temperature, everything that happens this side is what? It's a high pressure or a high temperature. So we can simply say this is what? This is low. Yeah? This is high. We can simply confirm this. Meaning, here we're going to have what? Pressure one. Everything that happens this side is what? In pressure one. Then we're going to have what? T1. Everything that happens this side will happen in temperature number one. So the evaporation will evaporate with a certain pressure that the certain refrigerators are operated with different pressures. And for an example, if you go to supermarket, maybe, just choose Spa, you go to Juice, and you go to maybe Bouchard, yeah? The pressures of fridges are different. The fridge might look the similar, but the pressures are different. Why? We set pressure according to like a certain substance that we are putting. You can't put 100 on a juice if it means you want to freeze it, né? And later on you want to drink it. You see, like that's what's happening with the pressure and everything. So the temperature as well is an important factor, because if we have to measure the temperature, if the temperature is high, there will be no freezing. The temperature must be low, so then we can have a freezing point. Now understand, né? It can be negative, it's fine, because freezing point, what is the point of freezing point? When you say something is below the freezing, somewhere like 0, 5, whatever there. Yeah? So this is happening with pressure 1. So after this, it compresses with a certain pressure, a certain temperature to a compression, where our compression will form what? Entropy. Then we are saying that in this form, we are going to have what? Entropy 1. Yeah? On this side, we are going to have what? Entropy 1. Depending on what? Depending on we can do this stage one. If we are here in stage one, we are first going to check the condition. Is it wet? Is it dry? Super saturated? Is it superheated? All those kind of things. Let's take it like this condition. It's wet or is dry saturated? No? Is dry saturated? We highly know that if this is dry saturated, if this is dry saturated, they are going to give us an X, which is a what? Dryness factor, ne? And we know that we can get what? Enthalpy for this. Then we're going to have heat at the stage one. It can be H1, whereby we're going to have HM plus X, HM. I don't know if I'm making sense. If you still give it the same thing, you can use entropy of S1. Where your S1 is going to be what? SF plus X, SFG. Do you get this? Take note that these two, when you're going to use on your table, it's going to be what? HG
minus HL.
This is when SG minus SF. When we are doing the refrigerator, we know this is the plant. When we are doing the refrigerator, we are not using a superheater table. They are going to give us a certain table, a special table, a lot of spanamoyo. If you see yourself going at the back of the on a steam table, you are going to get open the door. Can you understand? So there's a certain table that they're going to give us. They're going to give us all this component, and when you're going to plug them, all those things are going to happen. So this is going to do what? To compress. Again, to compress. So compression, this one, the factor of this is to control what? Refrigerant. This one controls refrigerator. It controls the refrigerator. That is where work is happening. There is a more work done. That is happening here. There is a work done. Work is happening here on a compression. Work is happening here on a compression. Now, so remember that the compression is between what? It's between low pressure and high pressure. Another factor of a compression is to do what? Convert pressure and temperature from what? From low to high. It converts what? It converts this pressure and the temperature into a high pressure and a temperature. Now understand? Meaning we now going to have what? A new P2 and a new what? T2. From where? From compression. This is going to compress it. With a certain work done, it's going to change the condition. Which this condition can be what? Can be superheater if they want it to be. It can be dry saturated if you want to be. It means we're going to have what? Stage 2. Stage 2. Take note that it's always the case that S1 is always equal to S2. This is always the case. Your S1 at condition 1 is the same as S1, S2 on the condition 2. This is always the entropy of S1 is equal to entropy of S2. So you're going to have this stage according to a condition where your refrigerator is operating. If your refrigerator is operating with a superheater, for an example, if it's operating with a superheater, you know that the entropy of H2 is going to be what? HG, CP, TSU, minus TS. Now, take note that on TS, what are you going to use? On TS, you're going to use this temperature of T2. Like, understand? Because you're not using the steam plant, here's going to be what? T2. The temperature of this side. That's what. So some people, when they are solving the refrigerator, guys, they are using graph. Now I'm not using graph. I'm showing you these things, how to use it with this table. Sometimes when you're going to work your questions, you find out that they say S8 and S everything solution. So and now I'm not using graph. I don't understand it. I understand this way. And if you do this way, you're still gonna get the same answers again today. So but the concept and everything is the same. So here on TS, you're gonna use this. If it's a what? If it's a superheater, but under what? Enthalpy. Remember, this is what? Enthalpy, right? So what about the S2, which is now we're saying is what? Entropy, right? Then your S2 is gonna be SG plus CP in TSU over TS. Something like this. Now understand that, if they need entropy, you're gonna do it that way. Can make a sense?
No.
Depending with what, with condition. They might say this condition is dry saturated and they come here in superheat. Or either way they can say it's dry saturated and they remove and everything be like this. I don't sort of like understand that now. So we now know, okay, here the evaporator is the one that takes the heat from the from our whatever that we put in the fridge. But now the heat is still inside the fridge. We have to take out that heat out of the fridge. We need to remove that heat. So what is the component that removes the heat? The component that removes heat is what? Is a condenser. Condenser takes the heat well outside the fridge. It's the one that takes the heat outside the fridge. If you go at the back of your fridge, let me now draw the side view of your fridge. This is the side view of your fridge. There's something in the back here. Do you see it most of the time? That is the condenser. It's the condenser. It's the one that removes the heat that happened in the inside of the fridge. Now understand? So this one do what? Remove heat from the inside of the fridge. Condenser is the one that removes heat from the inside. It's the one that removes heat from the inside. Then, so after condensation happens, there are going to be conditions where now our fridge will either be under cooling or our fridge will be not under cooling. We'll have conditions after condenser. Even the temperatures will change, everything will change, all those things. So condensation is the one that will bring condition of what? Under cooling. If this is under cooling, they're simply telling you that your stage 3 is going to be liquid. If it's under cooling, your H3 is what? Is HF. You understand?
Yeah.
On stage 3. We're now on stage 3. Under cooling, if it's under cooling, your H3 equals to what? HF. It means it's a liquid. Meaning it's what? It's a liquid. It's a liquid. Then, it means here on H3, here we're going to have H3. And if it's a H3, I probably know liquid, yes, we dominate it by HF. And we know when something is dry, we dominate it by HG. We know these things. When something is dry, we say it's HG. When something is liquid, we say it's HF. When something is HFG, what is happening here? We say when it's dry, it's HG. When it's liquid, it's HF. So what about this one? It's a wet dry. It means there's a wet and a dryness inside it. Like what are they doing? Yeah. So now we understand that the condenser will remove the heat out of the fridge from the inside. Then it will form the condition of undercooling. If the condition of undercooling is happening, then you know that your H3 equals to your what? Your HF. Then here on H3, if they say need an enthalpy of this, you can quickly go and run and find on your table, you get HF and employ it. But what about if there is no undercooling? What is going to happen with your H3? No undercooling. It means your H3 is going to be HG plus CP T2 minus T1. Again. It's going to be your T2 minus T3. I'm sorry. T2 minus T3. Your T2, you take it from here. And your T3 will be new temperature that the condenser will produce. Now understand, new temperature of what? Condensation, this one. New temperature of condensation. Oh, I'm a good teacher. It's a new temperature of condensation. Now understand the name? With whatever condition that this will take, it must go back to a throttle valve. What is the function of throttle valve? The first function of a throttle valve, kind of guys, we say this is a process. And a process is something that repeats itself, yeah? Something that moves, what comes around, what goes up must come back, yeah? So this went this other way around, so we need it, so it can go back to evaporation. So, throttle valve, the function of a throttle valve is to convert the process back to normal. You understand? It convert what? Convert process of
refrigeration. Refrigeration. Back to normal.
And another thing, convert from high pressure
and temperature
to low. Convert from what? High pressure and a temperature to what? To low pressure and temperature. You make a sense?
Yes.
You saw what the compression did. Compression convert what? The low pressure into high. And the throttling convert what? The high pressure into low. Understand? So here on stage four, we're going to have what? Stage four. After the throttle valve took place. Yeah? After the throttle valve took place, we're going to have what? Stage four. Meaning here on stage four, there is going to be a condition. The condition will depend if it's wet. Normally it becomes wet, so that if it's wet, we know that the evaporation can take everything from the beginning. Understand? That's why you can hear those sounds in your freezer. Say, like after some minute, you say, no. Understand? It's now the throttle valve. The throttle valve, if you go inside your fridge, especially this thing stays on top, there's a gauge here. You've got to gauge yourself. Why, what? That gauge, you actually gauge in this thing. Throttle valve, guys, is like an orifices. This is orifices. Orifices. You did power fluid. Orifices is like a tap. A pump, yeah? If you need too much of the water, you have to open the whole of it. Yeah? So the whole water will flow. So even here, when you want your fridge to be normal, you control the valve so that it should not remove a lot of, because condensation, it compresses, it takes from compression what? The refrigeration effect. So the refrigeration effect went here. So we say here, RE is happening. RE is happening from the throttling. Then we name this what? Refrigeration effect. We name this refrigeration effect. So this one controls what? Control refrigeration effect. Control RE. This thing. So here the way adjust another, you can put it to one. So it means there will be less gas that passes through here. You can put it to six, then there will be more gas passing and all those things. Now understand that, eh? So by this way, I think we are almost done. So can I erase here? So you realize that we did what? Pressure versus we had enthalpy. We had enthalpy and we had entropy. Yeah? You still remember the two, yeah? Whereby we said this is H, it's dominated by H, or is dominated by S. Yeah? So now I want us to do what? Enthalpy versus pressure. Let's do pressure versus enthalpy. Pressure versus enthalpy. We are drawing a graph. I want us to draw a graph. To those who will be interested to use a graph, or even if they ask you in Excel, draw the graph, you know what you're going to do this. This is P1. This is P2. The pressure from 1 is the pressure from this side. The pressure for 2 is the pressure from this side. Again. So we go to stage 1. We know that, oh, we got H1. Then we can plot our H1 here. Then here we have our H1. Next. Then we go to H2. Or we see that, oh, our H2, it can be wherever here maybe. Then we have our H2. Because after compression, work is done. So we'll have more enthalpy. Because work is done after compression. So we'll have more enthalpy. That's why H2 is bigger than H1. Then on condensation, we are going to have H3, which the liquid, it has like a low enthalpy. And then we can confirm this is our what? Our H3. Then we go to H4, it's a wet. Probably it's less than it's gonna be here. So we know that here we have what? H4. Now, this is how our diagram will look. Then we say that Let us join that thing.
According to what? To a saturated vapor line.
There is something called saturated vapor line.
Something saturated vapor line is a line like this. What is mignon?
It's a line like this.
Ne? Mignon around this line. So it's a line like this, but Fertina. On this line, there's a separation. There's a separation. You separate your line like this. Ne? When you separate your line like this, you say that anything that is inside, it's wet. Anything that falls inside this saturated line, it's wet. This we call a saturated vapor line. We call it this saturated. In example, they say, draw a saturated vapor line of this condition. They need you to draw this. So then, this is your saturated vapor line. So inside this, anything that falls inside, it's wet. And anything that touches this line, it's liquid. Anything that touches this line, it's liquid. Anything that touches this line is dry. Ne? And anything falls from this line over this side is superheated. I'm making sense. Anything that falls out of this line is superheated. Now let's assume that on condition one, our H1 was dry. Again, we make assumptions. On condition one, our H1 was dry. So we say that H1 is what? Dry. On condition two, we assume that our H2 was superheated. We want to draw a vapor line. We say that on H2, our H2 was superheated. On H3, we assume that it was liquid. Is HF liquid? On condition 4, we say it was wet. On 4, we say that it's wet. Like this. Now they say that plot your what? Your saturated line over this. Okay, what happened is this. We go to H1. H1 is what? Is dry. Is the line going to touch that point or what? We say that if the condition is dry, the line must touch. Again, so H1 is dry, ne? It means this line will touch. Ne? We go to H2. H2, we say that if your condition is superheated, then the point will fall under here. So it means it's not going to touch this. Ne? Then we go to H3. We say that if your condition is liquid, it will touch the line. Then we say, okay, this H3 is liquid, then it will touch. We say H4 is wet. And we say that if anything is wet, it will fall under the line. It means here it's not going to touch. Then you join your whatever. This is your saturation line, how you draw it. It makes sense. Or should I make another example? Yes. Yeah, okay, let me take questions first.
What did you say to the line?
Okay, divide it as a whole, no differentiate down. Come on, we need to critique, come on, we need to dry. Oh, understand? This line from here is dry. This line from here is liquid. Understand? And anything that falls on this condition, it's a superheater, it does not touch. And anything that falls under, it's a wet. We go to our H1. Our H1 is dry. Again, then we say if it's dry, it must touch the line. We go to H2. Our H2 is superheater. It's here. It's not going to touch. Ne? It's not going to touch this line. We go to H3, it's liquid, it's going to touch. We go to H4, it's what? It's wet, it goes inside. Ne? They understand the law? Then we automatically join. We know that our condition went from what? From H1 to H2, from H1 to H2, H3 to H4. Ne? Then we say that we join this, join this, join this,
join this. Then from here to here is compression. You can confirm it, it's compression from each one to this. Where the done is happening. Yeah, that's where the done is happening. If they say calculate where the done, they're simply telling you that this is from H1 minus H2. If you get your H1, you minus it with your H2, you're going to get work done. And if you are given the mass of the refrigerator, this is going to be like this. You multiply everything by what? Mass of the refrigerator. From here to here, your work done is happening. Then from here, it's what? It's from H2 to H3. It's here. That's your condensation. That's where your condensation is happening. Then you say here is where it's undercooling or no undercooling. Again, this is happening here. Do you remember? Then from here is what? H3 to H4. It's here. It's on a throttle valve. It's from H3 to H4. It's on a throttle valve. Then we go back from H4 to H1. That is where your what is happening. Your RE is happening. Your refrigeration effect. Then we say that RE is what? If you minus H1 with H4, you're going to get your RE. If they give you mass of the refrigerator, you can multiply with mass of the refrigerator. Am I making sense? A lot of sense, perfect. Serious? Work done is between H1 and H2, and the refrigeration impact is from what? It's from here to here. So these things, guys, they give coefficient of performance. If all these things is happening, it gives you coefficient of performance. When we say coefficient of performance is what? Is it work done? Is it RE over work done? Let's confirm it in our books, this equation. Okay, it's RE over work done. This is your coefficient of performance. Coefficient of performance, which we say that H1 minus H4, H1 minus H2. Something like this. Lantern of return. All these things, they're coming from where? Pressure versus enthalpy graph. Okay, so I want to go to what? Pressure versus entropy. I want to erase this one. Allow me to erase it. It's not on the entropy. Any question, guys? Let me take questions. Let me take questions. Or it means you are understanding. Now let's go to pressure and entropy. Let's go to pressure and entropy. We're going to have P1, we're going to have P2, yeah? Here, guys, what is happening? On this one, we only have on the paper. You remember, I said, what is this line? What is the name of this line? It's a saturated vapor line. On an entropy and on a pressure and an entropy, we only have two lines, which is this and this. Then we name this line what? Dry, saturated, and we name this what? Liquid, saturated. We only have these two lines. Your shape is not like this. I understand. Anything that comes inside is what? It's wet. Anything that goes is superheated. You now get this picture, then? It goes like this. I don't know what shape is this. I don't know what shape is this. It goes like this, and this shape, it goes like this. Understand? So this is the shape of entropy. I don't know how much you can make a framework of this. You know that when you speak about entropy, your shape is going to stay like this, and that one is a second shape. Ne? So here on the entropies, you are going to have S1, depending on your condition, If your S1 is dry, it means it's gonna touch here. Then, and your S2 is what, superheater, it comes here. And your S3 is what? Your S3 is liquid, it's gonna touch here. Ne? And your H4 is wet, it's gonna come here. Then it's automatically gonna join like this. Again, wait, this is your S1, your S2, your S3, your S4. Ne? Depending with conditions. Then you know this is happening from here to here to here to here. Again. So the formation of this will bring temperatures. It means from here to here we'll have a work done. I mean we'll have RE. From here to here we'll have RE, and from here to here we'll have what? Work done. This thing will be like it's something that is ideal. It's an ideal understanding. So we're going to have what? Ideal SOP. Something in idle days is something that was created without like is an assumption. It's an assumption. I understand. Idle SOP. So they assumed that T1 is going to be T1 minus T2. Let me confirm the it's T2 minus T1 because T2 is gonna be bigger than T1. Then these things they come from here. It's this T's. If they say calculate the idle SOP, you know okay, it's from here, and you substitute everything, then it is done. It is done. It is done. Another question that can come, they will say, calculate the heat of you have four components, remember. Calculate the heat of a component. Depending any component, you know that the formula for heat, the standard formula for heat is this. Net mass Cp change in temperature. We know this, net. They will come and say calculate the heat of the heat of condenser. Another standard formula for heat is this. Mass of refrigerant, entropy 1, maybe minus entropy 2. These two, we know them from steam plant. If you are working with it from the steam plant, if you are working with enthalpies, you use this, whereby the heat is equal with the mass of the fuel. Right? If you use fuel gases, you use this one. So here they will say, calculate the heat of a condenser. When they say they need heat of condenser, it's going to be what? MR into, you take H, between these two, you take H2, then you minus it with H3, then you can get your heat of a condenser. Either way, it can be what? Mass of a refrigerant, Cp into T2 minus T3. You know that your T2 is this one, and T3 is the temperature that happened after the condensation. Am I making sense?
Yeah.
Hey, if you're using this one, you're gonna come here. If you're using this one, you're gonna come here. Those are the heat. Those are the heat.
Yeah.
Sure.
So
T3, it will happen when this thing is no undercooling. Yeah? Or when every time when they say this is not undercooling, you just know you're going to work. Or not undercooling, just know you're going to work. But the concept is easy. And it's 3 months when they say no undercooling. Sometimes if you're undercooling, you know you're not going to work here too much. Look at the spanaka this side. Guys, this thing can be like this. This dry can come here. This dry can come here. Anywhere they want. It means you can have X1 here. You can have X2 here. You can have X3 here. You can have X4 here. Now you understand? And this thing, it kicks you back. It kicks you back. That if they need the heat of this, and we're not going to lay X1 here, I'm going to X3 here. You can say that. You can simply say that. You can confirm it actually. That MR equals to X2 minus X1. I mean X3. If you go to the axis, It even kicks you back to work done. You know that work done is what? It's a mass of refrigerant, H1 minus H2. It's H2 minus H1, right? It's like this. It can kick you back wherever you say that X2 minus X1. It can kick you back here. If you are working with X's, X2 is going to be X1. You know how to get X. If they give you driver's factor, friction, you use that formula and you do everything. Even on refrigerant effect, it still kicks you that H1 and H4, right? It's like this. This is the same as this X1 minus X4. Again, and on CPO, whereby MR into H2 minus H1 into MR H1 minus H4. It's like this. We know that, okay, COP, MR will simplify MR, okay? Then we left with X2 minus X1 divided by X1 minus X4. You can still get SOP using X's. It's still the same. It's still one of the same thing, depending on which conditions that they're giving you. It's still one of the same thing. It's counted when they're now giving you a lot of friction in your refrigerator. You say, we are never told of air. There is never told, I will see next block. Okay. Do you understand? Yeah. So if they give you with that, you can still manipulate and remove these things and put X's. Even on a simple light, if this is happening, you still have to remove those things because they are one of the same things. They're still going to give you one of the same thing. That's why. Here, if they say calculate the heat of evaporator, heater evaporator is going to be what? Mass of refrigerant, H between these two. Which one is bigger? Minus H4. What is this thing? This thing, let's speak about this. What is this? This formula is for what? It's RE. So it simply tells you that your key EVA equals to RE. This is what this simply tells you. It's true because you remember on that formula we say that the RE is happening between what? These two. This is where it's happening. It's 100% true what they're telling you there. If they say find the heat of a compressor, you're gonna do it. Mass of refrigerant, H2 minus H1. Between these two, this one will be big because work is happening. Work is done. Work is done. MR H2 is what? It's simply telling you that Q of compressor equals to work done. The heat of a compressor is the same as the work done. This is simply what they're telling you. And this one is also standard. Thanks, Billy, for that. Yeah? This one guys is always standard. That H3 is always H4. This one is always like this. This one is always like this. Always, when you start drawing your thing, you draw everything, you put this. This is always like this. It's always the case. It's always. Unless stated otherwise, yeah? So guys, I think I'm done. I think I'm done. The other thing that can come is this. You know these things are the circles? They might require you to do volumes. They might require you to do volumes. If they give you rotational frequency and a strobe length, you know that volume is what? Area multiplied by what? Strobe length, right? Your area is pi over 4. D squared multiplied by strobe length. You can get the volume. Ne? They sometimes come pashmishadi to the percentage. You know that the percentage is what? Percentage where you have VE and VS. This is your VE. You can get it from there. So volume. You did cycle. You know those volumes. No,
okay guys, just simply follow me. My name is Pulo Matlong. That's my email, matlongpa@gmail.com, Facebook, Leyengalangas Matlong. Twitter, type of yourself for the contact, guys. I don't have a, smartphone. You just follow me on Grams. Yeah. You see. This is me.
Yeah, because it's a journalist.